Good evening, everybody. My name is Seth Sacco. And to my left is Seth Petruzzelli.
Good day to you.
And to his left is Coringa Conway.
Hello.
I've been doing that a lot lately.
What, calling him?
No, I put my hand on my forehead and I go like this.
You're doffing your cap.
Yeah, but I think it's a isn't that a Muslim thing?
No, it's like good day. Because what you were doing is
yeah. Good day, sir. I've been doing that a lot. Like even strangers, I'm like, how's it going?
It's better than your. Yeah,
it's really weird.
What if it was a Muslim thing and that's like death to you? Know what I mean?
Yeah,
like death to America.
Sit in my cock.
It's kind of better than Europe, ma'am.
Yeah,
ma'am.
Ma'am. Yeah.
But I say hi. But when I say hi, I'm like, hi, how's it going? And I touch the forehead and do this.
No, I think this is like a Muslim thing, like that.
The tongue unravels.
Nobody likes them, anyways. Whatever.
Yeah. Exactly. Oh, by the way, together we are the Jungle Boys, and there's Coos is with us, as always.
Crazy Coos.
Yeah.
Oh, Carly.
Oh, and I heard a story about her this weekend.
Yep.
We start calling her fucking luggage.
Seriously.
She's been carried around everywhere.
Oh, okay, that story.
But
a lot.
She just can't. Carly's funny because it's nothing, and then it's BAM!
Yeah.
It's like.
It's like a thimble of beer, like
I'm feeling drunk right now. Yeah, but she drinks whiskey. For
there's
God
some videos too, by the way.
That's what I like.
Oh my God, there's video.
There's video.
Oh,
who took video?
Oh, I saw that too.
You saw it?
He took video.
I didn't take video. It was part of. I was on the video.
Oh,
so who took the video?
What was the video?
Pat took the video.
Pat took the video.
Wait, what time of the night was the video?
You were at.
We're at
Don Jefe's Tequila Bar, and Aaron was sitting there like this. I thought his teeth were going to go shatter out of his skull. And then along comes Carly. Sitting on Aaron's lap.
I thought I sat on a girl's lap.
No, you sat on my lap. And then you're like, I don't know, you just got unhappy with it because you looked at me like I was, what's wrong with you? And then like you just got up and I'm like, I don't fucking know what to tell you.
And then Aaron just kept looking. Have you seen this video?
No.
It's creepy, man. He kept looking at Pat's. His eyes were glowing and he's grinning. He's literally grinding his teeth like.
Well, who was that other girl named Molly, by chance?
I don't know her.
Yeah,
she might have been there, too.
Yeah.
In true form.
Dancing with Molly.
Now, here's what I don't understand is Carly tried to sit on another girl's lap, and no one facilitated this. Like, hey, scoot over, and let's see where this goes, because she was drunk.
Yeah.
No, it was Gabby. She was a shot girl, and I thought Pat was taking pictures, so I went and jumped on her lap. But he
that's right. You did pose, because I saw you posing, and I'm like, when I watched the video, I'm like, it looks like she's trying to take a picture, because she posed and smiled, and she didn't know it was a video, so.
Right. Yeah,
but can we talk about your other experience with the girl?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. So the night before, we went to see Josh at Pulse, the gay club.
Yeah.
So body shots ensued, and then.
Ooh.
Wait.
You were doing body shots off somebody?
No, they're doing it off me.
Wait, let's
oh, okay, sorry.
So let's explain for everyone at home. Pulse is what?
Pulse is a
gay bar.
Very extremely gay bar.
And gay leaning toward men, correct?
Wait, there's
okay. There's five dudes with banana hammocks flapping them in my face.
I don't even want to call them dudes. They look like 19-year-old lost boys. Like, literally.
So it's like a twink kind of place?
It's a twinkie.
They're kind of twink, yeah. They're wearing like tidy whiteies with like obviously stuff in there and just like kind of dancing like they're kind of confused.
Yeah.
It's
that's
really weird.
Actually, they're not even really good dancers. They kind of just right-color.
Just kind of like move.
Bouncing and moving.
Well, you don't really need to be
my God, I can't believe I'm here.
Yeah. He twinks.
Okay, so now let's get back to the body shots. Now that everyone has that visual.
Yes. So picture five dudes and dancing in banana hammocks and the light. Everything's white in the whole bar, of course, because white is a gay color.
Right.
So everything's white. And then I don't know how it came about, but we're like, there's body shots, yeah. And then Brittany, Josh's girlfriend,
right,
who bartends, Josh bartends at the club. He's totally straight.
We
think that he's straight.
Yeah, somewhere on the spectrum.
Yeah, and Brittany's his girlfriend. She's there, and Carly's there, the only two girls. So Brittany's like, I'll do a body shot.
In the whole place.
No. You said have me do a body shot off Brittany, and she was wearing a dress. So her.
That's
Josh
right. That's what I tried to get.
Oh yeah,
that's what I tried to.
Because that dress has got to go one way or the other, obviously.
Exactly. And then it was like, no, she can't. Carly's not wearing a dress. Let's put her up there. So Carly gets on the bar ever so gently and erotically.
Oh wait, did you ask your fetus's consent to have that body shot? Have you seen it?
What?
When she was wearing just quick aside. Now, when we both worked at Sin, and I say that in past tense, we'll get to that.
Yep.
When we both worked there, Carly came outside one night to where I was standing, and her corset was a little, what's the word I'm looking for?
The metal bars were bent, so it looked like I had a pudge.
Yeah,
you had a little belly?
The metal bars bent for some reason.
Because I had to drive in the corset, and when you sit down, the metal bars in the corset, that's supposed to stand straight.
Because what happens when you sit down?
Exactly.
little pooch.
Yeah, I'm because I kept poking it. I'm like,
so you Sako thought you were pregnant.
Yeah, right. I'm like,
he
yeah,
was
yeah.
Okay, good. But you got rid of that, hopefully.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, good.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah, you
on
got
the bar.
Rid of
there wasn't a pudge, was there?
No, there was no pudge. No, I thought I saw.
Yeah.
She sucked it so clean, I couldn't tell what was there. If there was pudge, she sucked it right out of your belly. So it amazes me, though, that a 23-year-old woman, not Carly,
Brittany,
doesn't know how to take a correct body shot. So what you're supposed to do, you're supposed to put your mouth on the belly button. Yeah. So here's the belly button. You put your mouth on the side, and then as they pour it in the stomach, it rolls to the belly button. As it's coming down.
Yeah.
So she puts her mouth almost there. They start pouring it. She waits till it gets full and starts dripping down Carly's obliques and her nipples and everything. And then then she just dives in and goes, like all over. I'm like, oh, what are you doing? I'm like, you're supposed to put your mouth there and gently suck.
No.
The juice off.
Let her
gently
lick.
Suck.
Yeah.
That's how you're supposed to think about it. That's the correct
coincidentally,
way to
like, well, you guys remember Chutes and Ladders?
I never played. Because
I could, like, move my shit around and be like, watch it. And then, like, right into the mouth.
Wow.
Like water forming through dirt, just takes all different angles.
Yeah,
and stuff
exactly.
Like the Grand Canyon.
Like if you take like if you go up to like the satellite shot, it looked like
it looked like your stomach.
Yeah, exactly. Like
nice. Sako has a Grand Canyon. Yeah. So then, but the thorn thing is what happened after the body shot.
Oh, I'm listening.
So Brittany sucked it dry, right? Mm-hmm. Carly gets up. I was like, she looks at Brittany.
What?
No. And then they embrace and they start making out.
What?
No.
Bullshit. That's
It was better than that. You were flirting with a gay guy. You don't even know what happened. She kisses her way up my stomach, up to my mouth. Then I sit up and we start making out.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. So you kissed before you stood up.
Her way was a lot more sensual. I like it that way.
No. Okay.
Because Seth was flirting with a gay guy that worked there, so he didn't really see all of it.
Me?
Yeah.
You.
Yeah.
You said Sako.
Oh, dude, by the way, are you pregnant?
No.
Because looks like you've been partying a lot lately. Dude, you literally came into the gym the other day.
Because I was relaxing my stomach and it was bleh.
Yeah.
Anytime I relax my abs, like, I have like the block abs, you know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah.
He knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I have those too.
Yeah. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
So, but anyway, the point is, that was her first ever girl on
kiss.
And
where the fuck was the video for that? Like,
I missed the key
on
that.
Did Josh get some pictures from it?
Not of the kissing.
Okay.
Of the bar, of us at the bar.
Now that you've kind of dipped your toe in that pool, I think it's time for you to take Whitley with you next time.
Hey, what is with your friend Whitley? She got like super skinny and kind of weird.
She's always been
skinny.
Yeah, like she's like really skinny. She was over here for the...
I thought she got kind of loose.
Yeah, she doesn't look right. Like something's wrong.
Oh, I didn't think
she have AIDS or something.
Shouldn't have like a dick coming out of her.
The only thing is that
she was here
when she first came on. She was just a vegetarian, but now she's
maybe
gone.
And maybe it was a long hair or something. But she just looks like super skinny. Like.
I had meat here, and she said she wouldn't eat it. I offered her my peach.
Right, that's what I'm saying. She's a vegetarian.
What? Your peach?
Like, I offered her my peach, and she
I've got
my
this
peach.
Roast in my room.
Could
There's
eat
no room
peach
in the kitchen.
For
No, but she came over for the pool party Sunday, Saturday,
yeah.
Saturday, and yeah, she got in her little bathing suit. She looked good.
How was that?
I was only here for an hour because I had prior engagements with Dominique.
Yeah.
Dominique won a...
you guys went to a vacation
New Smyrna Beach.
Right?
New Smyrna Beach. She won it. So Pat had plans, though, to have a pool party here.
Yeah.
So
that's some good times that day. We had a guy.
I don't know. I left for everyone got here. I was here for Whitley and Carly and John Morehouse, the manager at my gym. I was here for that, and then I had to leave.
Yeah.
But at least I got to see Carly and... Oh, Carly and Whitley, though, are probably the two of the worst volleyball players I've ever seen in my goddamn life.
I don't know. You're pretty bad.
Yeah. Well, that pool is really not meant for volleyball.
That's why I built it.
No,
what do you mean?
We had a good weekend the other weekend, like here with volleyball.
What do you mean?
It's a player.
It's a sport bottom.
Because
three,
it spends
three,
more
five.
Time rolling across your yard than it does anything else.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't have professional nets to stop it, but it's
God.
Yeah.
That is what it is.
That's what the other people not playing volleyball are for.
Yeah.
To go get the fucking ball.
Not me. I just watch people run after the ball.
But you guys suck.
Yeah.
Guys suck right now.
Yeah, it was still good, though. I was very proud of Carly coming out of her shell, especially with the girl and girl.
Yeah, man.
Whatever.
It was exciting.
Not only...
It was good. I'm not saying it's bad.
Not only is she half a beer in, she's making out with chicks. Like, that's two combinations.
She had two glasses, drinks of whiskey, and then maybe one girly glass shot.
Yeah.
No, and then I had another half glass of whiskey because you made me chug it before we left.
No, I didn't.
One.
If you remember correctly,
did.
I said, suck a little bit, and then we'll leave. And you went like this.
I want to go ahead and watch this
so
video.
Wait, so this is a...
halfway to the glass and go till there.
No, bullshit.
Yeah,
wait, it was like a very tip. I was like, go to there, and it was like a little bit off the top. I swear.
So this
I was sober, I know.
So this is a Friday night where you guys go to Pulse, leading into a Saturday where they're in the pool.
Yes. Yeah. So
how
she did back-to-back, and then she went out that night and got the picture with Aaron.
Yeah, so how did this not lead into everyone watching her and Whitley hook up?
Oh, I don't.
Because Whitley left at like 5.
Yeah, Whitley had to.
Oh, is that the video?
Yes,
video. Sorry, guys. We're not even paying attention to you. We're literally watching the phone.
Yeah.
Maybe you tried kissing. You're trying to kiss me.
No.
Wait, what? No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. All right.
Now we're literally just giving commentary off the video.
Yeah. So maybe we'll.
I'm not gonna throw my phone.
So
I'm not throwing my phone.
Maybe we'll.
I'll show it to you later.
We'll put that video maybe on the podcast.
So last week you went on vacation again.
Yeah. Okay. So that was that weekend. The week before that.
It's pretty funny.
I was in the Keys from Tuesday through Friday for mini lobster season.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I've been to Key West many times,
mm-hmm.
but. There's a weird thing when you go to Key West. Like, have you been there?
Anyone been there?
Key West? Not since I was like 12.
Have you been to Key West, Carly?
Of course.
Okay, there's a certain type of people, a person that lives in Key West.
The Conk Republic.
Gay and Hebrew, or not Hebrew, sorry. What? Gay and hippie.
Yeah.
Whiskey Tango. Really, really
whiskey
tango,
tango.
White
yeah.
trash.
Yeah,
big yeah, time. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Big time. It's really gross. Every club we went to, everyone had sandals, shorts on, which is cool. I like the laid back.
That's like
Key West. I love the laid back atmosphere, but everyone that walked by had a certain scent of poo.
Yeah.
Yeah, hippie like, fucking.
It's poo. Not patchouli, but just poo.
Poop,
like they have a diaper on that's full of shit.
Yeah.
So, but
they're disgusting people. I mean, there's no two ways about it.
Yeah,
that.
They are disgusting people. So I went lobstering. Nothing funny about this, but we went lobstering. We caught like 100 lobster. It was fucking amazing. The one funny thing that did happen while we were lobstering.
Let me guess. Lobster like latched onto your nipples or something with
no,
its claws?
They're not the claw lobster. That's northern lobster.
Oh.
Florida lobsters just have big antenna.
Oh. That's
Wait, gay. They don't have claws?
Everyone is surprised by this. Are you serious? Nobody knows what a Florida lobster looks like.
I really just don't get down on lobster. I don't know. It's all right. Jeez. It's not a big deal.
So anyway, okay, we find this big hole full of probably like 30 lobster, right? So imagine about 7 guys around the hole, snorkel gear, a tickle stick, and a net trying to get these lobster out, catching one by one. So all of a sudden, I'm floating this way. I float my ass this way, pull my pants down, and I'm like, I have a snorkel on. So I'm like, gosh, roar, roar. And as they hear the roar, they look up, and I'm fucking squeezing out the biggest shit ever. It's like leaking. It's coming, and I see it still attached to my butt, and it's all the way up here, like floating in the waves. And everyone's like throwing their tickle sticks and nets off, like, stop, we're sitting right here, and they can't get out of the water because they're catching lobster.
Yeah, they're underwater. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, it's the greatest. So it all eventually comes up, and then all you see is, like it would picture, like, you are a mini.
Like in space?
Like you're a midget.
Like
no, yeah, yeah. Like, picture yourself being, like, a little midget, like a fraggle, and you're sitting in scuba gear in a toilet, and you see the shit floating in the toilet. That's what it looked like. There's just tons of shit floating above us, and nobody wanted to come up to get air because there was shit floating in the whole thing.
Dear God, bro.
That was disgusting.
That sounds terrible.
Ruined my fucking day.
Oh, it was the best. It
God.
Was the best. I laughed. I'm a sick fucker. I was laughing my ass off so hard.
First of all,
never going scuba, swimming, or anything with Seth.
Just learned, A, that Florida lobsters don't have claws, which now I have no interest in them whatsoever.
Yeah. The tails are good. That's what you eat, the tails.
Oh.
Fucking cockroaches.
We'll put a picture of a Florida lobster.
Just another reason.
Just a fast glimpse of it so people know.
It's another reason for me not to go in the fucking water at all. Because I don't know if you guys heard this, just a quick aside. 2 weeks ago, a girl off the coast of France who was like swimming in, it's not the Riviera, it's like some other like place that's almost as famous.
Yep.
Got bitten in half by a fucking shark. A 15-year-old.
What kind of shark?
They didn't say.
Probably like a great white. A great white.
The French eating kind.
The week before I went down there, a great white, which is never in
right,
south,
it's warm.
Was spotted 20 miles south of Key West, right
really?
Where we were fucking swimming.
Isn't it too warm?
That's what I thought, but it was spotted. They have it on video and everything.
Wow.
So the two sharks that I did see, three sharks. I saw two nurse sharks and a bull shark. The nurse shark story was pretty cool. I was swimming. It's about 3 or 4 foot.
Did it take a huge dump?
It didn't, but it went up to a lobster hole, grabbed the fucking lobster, and this was cool to see nature like right in front of my face.
Yeah.
Grabbed the lobster, bit it, shook it, and like ate it right in front of me, and which in turn made us find a lobster hole because it ate the lobster. As soon as it saw us, it took off. And then right after that, though, we had spear guns with us for this time. It was like dawn. It was just morning.
Worst idea ever.
Oh, yeah.
This is gross.
And, we're swimming.
I guess we're not getting Bud Light as a sponsor.
Eye to eye with a 6 or 7 foot bull shark. And these are the fucking mean
fuckers. Those are the ones who go out of their way to attack
you. As soon as it saw us, it turned to the side. Socko, I shit you not, its belly was us three put together. It was round. It was so fat. It was fat as shit. It looked like it just ate tons of lobster.
It's like...
Yeah, like, yes, the napkin's still around his neck.
Yeah. Bib.
Yes, bib.
Yeah.
So as soon as we saw that, we got up. We're like, hey, guys, that's Spectre boat. Yeah, yeah. And we swam backwards with our spear guns facing the direction, like this. Like, facing it like this with our spear guns.
Like, what's his name? Like, in the Ang Lee film where he's, like, jumping backwards for 5 minutes in slow motion? Like, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So, and then the third time I saw a nurse shark, it was in, like, really nice water. It was, like, super clear, another location. It was a big nurse shark. It was probably, like, another 6-foot nurse shark we saw. It swam.
Well, they don't attack people, right?
Oh, they're fine. Yeah, yeah. They're fine. So that was my shark story. It's pretty exciting.
That's hysterical.
Yeah. So I know you were talking about your job.
Yeah. Okay. So
you said you was part of the next part of the podcast. So.
Right. So, Carly and myself used to be employed at this nightclub downtown
called Sin.
Called Sin.
Well, we've talked about it many times on the podcast, so people listen to it.
Yeah. If this is your first time listening, listen to the other ones. which, if you get this in time. Who knows? We may not even be alive when you listen to this.
Yeah.
So apparently they never paid their rent because there's now an eviction sign on the front door. And I heard from someone else that the place was actually ransacked too. I don't know
like
why.
Like someone stole shit?
Like someone ransacked the place.
Probably the owners to get every little bit of money. To fucking,
insurance maybe. Yeah. Yeah.
We should have ransacked it and took all the alcohol or something.
Fuck yeah.
You guys had the inn. Oh. Did you have a key?
So how did it actually go down? Like, did they explain anything to you?
They texted me saying that they sold the liquor license for $300,000.
They said we don't want any little sluts that make out with girls working here anymore.
I guarantee that's a lie. There's no way that they got $300,000 for that liquor license.
And that the new owners were going to turn that place into a sports bar. I asked if
we don't have enough of those.
Yeah, exactly.
And I asked if they're going to keep any of the employees. They said they didn't know because they were completely renovating.
That means no.
And then they said, I'm sorry this happened. He's like, when I come back, because he was in Atlantic City, when I come back, I'll find you a place. I'll get you hooked up somewhere.
Atlantic City spending all the money that he just got from stealing all their shit.
Yeah, exactly.
And then, it's been a week.
Well, things had been going downhill continuously. Like,
did you write that?
Like, people, there were nights when nobody would show up. Yeah. So I kind of saw it coming. So
dude, every time I was in there, it got busy for maybe 30 minutes and then emptied out.
There
probably because we were dancing like assholes.
No, probably because that place sucked is my guess.
Dude, you know how many places open and close downtown Orlando?
It happens
literally
all the time.
Monthly.
Well, I had kind of seen the writing on the wall, and I started looking for a job about a month ago. And I got this job at a fertility clinic.
That's the best job ever.
It really is. And I just do kind of like analysis and data entry and writing letters.
Do you get to analyses on analyze dude's sperm?
No, but I kind of know how much things cost and what they do.
How much does sperm cost?
Well, to have it frozen, to have it frozen with no.
Fucking give me buy me a beer and I'll give you some sperm.
Just like shoot it into the freezer. No, it's like $500 a year just for them to freeze it and hang on to it.
How about I give you a beer and I give you my sperm, too?
That'll work.
But, like, if you want, like...
One for one.
If you want, like, a chromosome check for, like, certain things, it costs, like, $2,500.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. So I could really go in there and freeze my sperm for $500 and get a vasectomy?
A year, yeah.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, it always concerns me, though. Do they show... Excuse me. Do they ever like tell you like the pros and cons of freezing your sperm? Like is the kid going to come out like a Neanderthal?
Like, their consultation, like they have all that risk, stuff going on. But what's funny, the funniest thing about my job is my boss. She's not really my boss. I guess she's just kind of the person I'm working with. Because I don't even know
the person I have to answer to.
No, I don't even have to answer. Like they're just like, here's all this stuff. Here's what we want you to do. You have like 4 weeks to do it.
And you're like, this is my stapler.
Yeah, dude, they move me around a lot, man. Like, I finally have an office now. It's nice. I have a nice office.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
You're going to sit here 4 weeks doing shit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. But my boss's name is funny. I want you to take a guess.
Does it have to do with the work that she does?
Hamid Abdul-Majid?
No.
It doesn't have to do with the work she does?
No, it's just random. It's just randomly funny. Yeah, it's a she.
Well, you got to give us some sort of
hint. Come on.
Okay, dude. It's a show that you really like.
Oh. Her name is... Oh, I know, wait.
He doesn't know.
Yeah, Griffin.
What? Her name is Doctor Who.
No way.
Dr. H-U, Doctor Who.
Oh, H-U. Right.
Her name is literally awesome. Doctor Who.
I love Doctor Who.
Yeah, Doctor Who's awesome.
Yeah.
Did you bring that up to her, I hope?
No.
Dude, you have to have a ringtone like, with Doctor Who theme.
Like,
and then
it was
just walk
TARDIS,
by and
like,
catch it. Woo-hoo!
I guarantee. Yeah. She's a real like a good,
I love that.
Sitcom style like Chinese lady where she's like real.
Oh no, you know him here. Yeah.
Spam soy spicy.
Yeah, that kind of thing. Like,
how much do I need to do the chain 7 days? No time all. Good luck, everybody else.
Yeah.
Jesus, that's fucking awesome.
So that's what I do now. I work with Doctor Who at a fertility clinic.
Doctor Who.
Oh, that's good. You still trying to get your teaching job,
yeah,
though, correct?
Yep.
What? So this job marks your 57th, 58th job?
Yeah, something like that.
I'm not even joking, people. Like, he's had
50.
It's them, not you.
Yeah.
No,
of course, always.
It's definitely somebody else.
Yeah. It's definitely not you.
Well, when you take in consideration all my part-time jobs and stuff, all you know, whatever else, I mean, situational stuff happens and
that's crazy.
On. Well, a lot of these things, too, I had to start working as a teenager, so I racked up a bunch of jobs right away.
Wait, was there one good story where, God, what was it? You working at a burger joint, and did you punch someone, or did you throw up on something? I can't remember.
Oh, Steak and Shake. Yeah. I know. I see. Either I lose my job because I throw up or punch
or punch somebody. Those are the two reasons.
Yeah.
Either, or you do the same. You punch somebody, then throw up on them.
Yeah.
Tell us that story.
So, I am, like, probably 18 or 19, and I move up to Gainesville, and one of the first jobs I got was at a Steak and Shake, okay? And I'm the early morning.
I just see you cramming down all the fucking steak burgers down your gullet.
Oh, dude, I wish.
Dipping them in milkshake. And
they wouldn't. Okay, here's how that works against you at Steak and Shake, especially when you're the first guy in. Like, there's three shifts, like 3 8-hour shifts.
Yeah.
And I had to be there at like 5 in the morning.
Oof.
And because they have their menu is the same.
Perfect time for a steak burger.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Yep. So the stuff hasn't been switched off the line yet. There's like nacho cheese and all that old stuff on the line. And I'm not feeling well because I haven't had a day off. Because I was working three jobs at the time. I was working at Shan's in the cafeteria.
Was this number 17, 18, 19 of your jobs?
Yeah,
or
exactly.
Somewhere
around? Yeah. I was working at a bookstore. I was working in the underground cafeteria at Shan's Hospital. I was working at Steak and Shake. So I was feeling like I was just really run down and I was not feeling well. So you get your little setup cause you get these little cubes of beef and they're stacked in there, like hundreds of them.
Yeah.
So you just pop them on the grill and you flatten them out and then you just like, you know what I mean? You're like flipping them and you're pressing them. Yeah.
You're doing the Japanese choo choo train.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And the grease is kind of getting to me.
Oof.
And the nacho cheese is kind
of
getting to me.
The wafting of all the different smells.
Yeah.
your boss, Bob, just took a huge shit in the toilet.
Exactly.
That wafts at you.
Yeah, exactly. So what's happening, I'm just like, I feel it in my stomach, but I'm like, no, I'm not going to throw up. I'm not going to throw up. And it just fucking went from a stomach pain to just like, oh, here it comes. So I turn to miss the grill, and I throw up in the beef bucket where all the beef is. And then I realize, I'm like, oh, you just like throw up on like $100 worth of beef. So I turn and I throw up on the fucking grill.
It starts cooking.
And then it cooks.
I wish I was
and it, like the acid from my stomach. I throw up just fucking telling the story. The acid from my stomach is cooking on the grill. So it like, hold on a second. It's bringing back really bad memories. So I turn my face all the way around, and there's this guy
sitting fucking far behind me. Like the Exorcist?
Yeah. No, I turn around, and I'm not throwing. I'm like holding my mouth, and he sees me, and he's just like looking at me, and I throw up in the fucking trash can right in front of him.
Jesus Christ.
And I leave, and I'm like holding it as I run.
Is it coming out?
And I just like stop at the other trash can, and I fucking throw up. And then,
I wish I would have seen
one of the servers goes and calls the boss, boss. And the boss comes in, fucking, like, everyone had left by now.
Because the smell.
Yeah,
like,
I'm in the bathroom.
I bet you this smells like the inside of, what's Luke Skywalker cuts the, what's that damn name of the?
It's a Wawa.
I bet you smelling it.
Oh, like a Tauntaun.
There you go, Tauntaun.
Yeah.
I bet you smells
like
a Tauntaun stomach.
Exactly, yeah. So the boss comes in and I'm just sitting in the fucking bathroom. And
like this?
Yeah. I'm actually sitting next to the toilet. Like looking. I'm me and the toilet.
Wait, you're on the floor Like, with your hand on the toilet, just like,
No, just like on my shoulders leaning up against the urinal, because I threw up in the urinal.
God almighty.
And me and the urinal are looking in the same direction, kind of.
Gotcha, okay.
And the boss comes, and he's like, you know you're fired, right? And I'm like, really? Yeah, I'm going to go home.
How could they fire you that, though? Like, you got sick off their stuff. Say you ate one of their burgers, and you got sick. You should sue them.
Well, apparently, I was cussing a lot and loud.
Fuck, bro! Yeah, I can't, shit, like, bro!
Yeah, I don't even remember that part. I just remember, like, heaving. Like, I don't even know what. And I was just like, the fucking taste in my mouth on the drive home was so fucking bad. But I knew, I was pissed out at losing the job, but I knew I had a good story.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I wish I was there to see something like that.
So, like, can you imagine, though, the person who had to clean up the fucking beef bucket?
Oh, the beef bucket's one thing. Scrape the shit off the grill. The grill is fucking.
Oh, they
definitely literally have nothing but ground beef in that bucket with meat covered in barf.
Bull.
Yeah.
And they have to, like, definitely disinfect the grill. I don't know if they have to, like, they have to throw the grill out.
Just order, like, pick it
order
up.
A whole new $10,000 grill. Yeah. Well, that one's done.
Yeah, exactly.
Fuck. Did you cost the whole company $10,000?
It may be out of business now. Who knows?
I hope so. That would be even better of a story.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of stories, Aaron and I actually have another travel story, right? We went up to Fort Walton Beach.
Yeah, that was crazy times.
Yeah.
And that's in the Panhandle, correct?
Yeah. And there, it's very true what they say about the South is from about a little bit north of, like, Ocala to Virginia. No, I'm talking about, like, the actual South.
Oh, to Virginia. Yeah.
So we're right in the middle of fucking bumfuck.
Yeah.
White trash, hillbillyville.
There's military testing facilities all over this fucking place.
Yeah. So, well, anyway, on the way up, before the military testing story, Aaron and I got a call from a modeling agency who got our name through one of our friends that's doing a film for Nat Geo.
Yeah.
And they're like, hey, they need fighter models to go to Venezuela to take pics Saturday or Sunday.
Yeah, we call it print work, right?
Print work for Rome, actually.
Yeah.
So me and her are like, oh, fuck yeah, we'll do it. Let's do this. Blah. I had my passport overnighted up to Fort Walton, blah, blah, blah. Oh, the only thing you need, you have to stop to get pictures of yourselves. Like, oh, we're driving to Fort Walton. Where the hell we can do this? So me and I are like, oh, shit. We pull over the first time on the side of the road at a damn rest stop. We have to take our shirts off at a rest stop right by Fort Walton. So in the middle of fucking bumfuckville, do push-ups, do some sit-ups.
Get your pump on.
Get all pumped
get
up.
Get pumped, yeah.
And I'm sitting there posing. Like, as sexy and as buff as I can in front of all these fucking
roofers, like these fucking manly men.
They're like roofers. They're doing construction too, so they're all looking at us like,
what the fuck?
Fucking figs.
And it's just like, it's obvious, like, people stop at rest stops to bang people. Like, that's like a known gay stop. So it looks like we're just posing to try to fuck people. Yeah. It's so bad.
You're rolling out the fucking welcome mat.
So Aaron does his pose. We start driving, and apparently Aaron got this idea, like, you know what? I don't like my picture. We're going to stop again. I'm like, Aaron, are you fucking kidding me?
It didn't go through the first time either. We had to do it again.
So we stopped the second time, and Aaron just did it, opposed for a second time. But this time, we at least had somewhere, we went around back.
Yeah.
So people saw us around back.
Oh, and then, no.
Yeah, so we walked around back. Aaron took his shirt off, did the thing. And then before he puts his shirt on, he starts walking out front with his shirt off. So it looks like we just walked around the corner with his shirt off and shit like that.
Oh,
it
God.
It was awful. And then we get all that done. We send all that shit. I overnight my passport. I tell everyone at home, you know, I have to watch my dogs, blah, blah, blah. And then we get there. Oh, yeah, they changed their mind. They don't want fighters anymore. I'm like, are you fucking serious?
Yeah. Not only that, like, I don't know if you guys realize this or not, but Venezuela is now a third world country.
Yeah, but on the way there, I had friends, and I posted on Facebook, I had friends, like, sending me, hey, I'm in Venezuela right now. When you get here, let me know. By the way, fucking when you get here, if we don't meet up, enjoy the girls, because it's fucking out of control here, bro, especially with you guys. And we're like, oh, my God.
Enjoy the rebels and their machine guns.
Yeah, that's where we were, too. But,
enjoy their sisters.
We'd be on the beach posing with rum. Yeah. So it should be fun.
With rum.
With rum. So... And then you had a little military maybe story?
Yeah, so on the way down there, you pass all these crazy military testing facilities.
Like, and no trespassing.
No trespassing, and like there's like guard fucking checks and shit like that. Well, long story short, we do the fight thing, you know, set aside some t-shirts. We go out afterwards for the after party, and we get insanely drunk. And when I mean insanely drunk, I mean insanely drunk.
Yeah.
And one moment I'm like there, and I'm like, what's going on? I'm just trying to like walk around and just get shit straight, and I'm in the club. And next thing you know, I just wake up on a beach, like literally, like going from like oh to like, oh, and it's like wind's blowing, and I'm on some fucking beach. And I don't mean like a beach in Daytona where there's like buildings behind me. Like, I'm in an abandoned beach. Yeah. There's like, nothing.
Like, you know when they stormed Normandy yeah. with all the fucking metal X's, yeah. like the things they put in the ocean yeah, so you yeah, can't yeah. pull a boat up?
Yeah.
That's probably around. Yeah.
Nothing around me. And like, I've got different clothes on. Like, I've got no shoes, no wallet, no phone. And I'm like, oh my God, what the fuck? So I just start walking. And I walk and I walk and I get to like this guard shack has this like on a road and it has like the single fucking things, you know, things that
yeah,
come
yeah,
down.
Yeah,
that's like
little arm.
It's like a checkpoint.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what the fuck is this? There's no cars passing. There's nothing. There's nothing anywhere. So I decided not to embrace the fucking guard shack. Like, yeah. No, I decided not to do it because it was creepy as shit.
Yeah.
And it's like daylight. It's like daybreak.
Yeah.
So I fucking turn around and start walking, and literally, dude, I'm in my head like the world's fucking ended.
Yeah.
Like I don't see anybody. Like something had happened.
Like, in between. Somewhere, Uncle Joe's laying face down in the sand, like half his face covered.
Like a Twilight Zone episode, yep. like where the world ended while you're fucking having a blackout drunk night.
Yeah.
I finally walk what seems like 2 miles, like barefoot, fucking laughing at myself, like the world's ended, like the worst yeah. shit ever. I get to like this fucking complex finally, and like. They're like, oh, hey, what's up? You're just on this military testing site. What are you doing? Help me. I don't know where I'm at. What's going on? Where is everybody? It's 7 a.m. What are you talking about? What are you doing? I'm like, I don't know. So they call me a cab. And we get back to the hotel. Seth, like, just wakes up. All right, man, let's do the 7-hour drive on the way home. And we fucking literally just go back 7 hours.
But he told me the story. I was like, oh, you got to be shitting me.
Yeah, I kid you not, man. It was fucking crazy. Like, I literally was almost crying. In fact, there might have been a few tears.
Because you might have woken up in Guantanamo Bay. Like, what are you doing here?
No shit.
Literally.
I got on a boat not knowing. Just fell asleep. Yeah. And they don't know you're on the boat. And they just take you off.
There was nothing around.
You might have ended up in Venezuela.
Yeah, exactly. It's either like you woke up in a zombie movie or in like Weekend at Bernie's 3. We're like,
see, that was that was the fucked up thing about it was like, all this time about being into zombies and the world ending, like, this is fucking scary. I'm like laughing, yeah. like, why? Oh my God.
It's not that fun when it's true.
It was freaky, dude. It was really fucking freaky.
But like, sharks on one side, military on the other. Like, you got no chance.
What's this deep double
penetration? Double penetration. Thing. Okay.
What?
Now, here's the thing. I don't know if you guys have noticed on you know, how there are like certain trends in porn.
Yeah.
I've just seen a lot of double penetration pop up in the.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know why. Maybe there's just more of it. And it prompted this question. You know how usually like it's set up so that like balls don't touch that much? I assume that's why. I mean, access to like in that kind of close quarters, you know, there's going to be some kind of.
Rubbage, yeah.
Yeah. But. What I've seen, or at least, you know, I didn't do a whole lot of exploring. I mean, I watched for a couple seconds, and obviously I turned it off and
did
something else. More, you know, productive with my time. But they made, like, a dick sandwich. Like, you know how normally, like, it's chick here, dude on the bottom, and then dude kind of on top?
Yeah, yeah.
And they're trying not to associate? Well, it was like, you know how when a hamburger, you squeeze it, and the meat kind of comes out, and the buns are touching?
Yeah.
It was like, dude's balls were, like, flapping up against each other, and I'm like,
was it a gay porn too?
No, it was just a chick. I mean, she was getting her fucking, you know what I mean? She was getting stuck for sure.
Yeah.
But it was like, at what point is there too much friction?
Nah, that's not gay. Balls slapping is not gay at all.
But
when they're doing it with
their thighs were like crickets. Their thighs were like touching and shit.
Thighs a little weird. Yeah. Thighs more intimate to me than balls.
Yeah,
touching.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the inner thigh.
Right.
Like if I was going to rub.
You're scissoring sort of.
Yeah, like scissoring.
It's like, it's also to me like triangulating your position. Like balls just, I mean, it's willy-nilly. You're either going to hit or not. I mean, they're just flying around.
Yeah, yeah.
But like if you get the thighs working too.
Yeah,
the thighs. Then you know balls. Yeah. That's way too like.
It's too. It is pretty intimate. You're right.
Yeah,
but I still be down.
But here's the thing. If you could still stay hard, like I mean, what is that?
Oh, dude, you're hard because you're into the sex.
Yeah, the chick. But can you? I mean,
it doesn't matter what it's in. It feels the same.
But I mean, assuming though that like you're straight, it would be off-putting to be on a dude's thighs and
true.
The balls just slapping around.
You just gotta put it out of sight, out of mind. Just like you don't think of like.
So you're just like
your mom or dad when you're having sex. So
yeah, I mean.
Oh, that's what I think of to get
I just replaced the girl underneath me with myself, and then I start
smashing puppy heads with a hammer.
Oh Christ!
Oh God! That
just made me start crying. Yeah, it's horrible.
It really, and then it puts me in a whole other set of level.
What
thing
if you
thought.
Like? How about two puppies DPing another puppy. You ever thought about that? It's adorable.
It's so cute. Yeah. Speaking of cute, let's get to my
let's get off that subject right away.
Yeah. So with all the talk about beaches, and I was actually just at New Smyrna Beach this past weekend.
Oh, that's where the vacation was?
Yeah, which I didn't even talk about, really. And the New Smyrna thing actually really ran at home. Like, being with him on Fort Walton was there, and I thought of all the stuff.
Well, plus you were Key West, too. That's also
plus cool. I was Key West, plus New Smyrna. So it's nothing but fucking trashy beach for me.
Yeah. The
Silverback Sand Beach.
Yep. Yeah. So in honor of that, I wrote, the seven reasons I have a love-hate relationship with the ocean / beach. Okay. Number one, this is a real quick one. The ocean, much like Kim Kardashian, is it's a giant toilet. It's pretty gross.
Oh, God.
On the flip side, where else can I simultaneously use a tickle stick to net a lobster, all the while tickle out my own brown eel at my ass?
Oh.
Another benefit to shitting in the ocean, no toilet paper.
It's fucking gross, dude.
Pooping in the ocean, equals caring for your environment.
God, I've had sex in the ocean. God.
I get the sex, too. My dog's going crazy, sorry. Who in their right mind wants to be out in cloudy water and not see anything past their waist?
Definitely the fucking, not the girl got bitten in half.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, wait.
Hate the ocean.
Isn't that how Sokka feels every time he tries to take a piss and find his penis?
wait, go through that again. I'll laugh. Wait, what is it?
Isn't that how Sokka feels every time he tries to find his penis while taking a piss? Can't see past your waist.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. Kind
no, of I usually just let it start, and then I you know what I mean? I
just like, find
it. Yeah. Just target after that.
Wait, you pee, and then you follow the piss stream down to your dick.
It's like what happens when you get lost in a jungle. You just follow the river out.
That's true.
Yeah.
All right. The sun. The sun is great for us.
Oh, I know where this is going.
we're all made from an exploding sun, so it has to be good for us, right?
Yeah.
The only problem with too much of a good thing is having to look like a twice-baked, leather-skinned, native beach fish dogs that look like the mother from Something About Mary.
Yeah.
What'd you think I was going with that?
I thought you were going to make a Kirsten Dunst in an Interview with a Vampire joke about Aaron.
Flaming him on fire. Yeah. That's another idea. Sharks. Sharks are the definition of love-hate. I love them on Shark Week. I love them on the wall of a seafood restaurant. Mm-hmm. And I love that they normally only attack burnt-out, long, blonde, straw-hair surfers.
Or in this case, 15-year-old girl. Jesus.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
That's all they found was her lower half. Shark literally ate the top half of her and then swam off.
He's a tit shark, not an ass shark.
He's a tit shark. Dude.
I'm definitely a tit shark.
On the flip side, I hate them because they rarely eat dark minority meat.
Yes!
Yeah.
That's because they don't go out to the ocean. They know what the fuck's
up. Oh, bullshit! Yeah. That's another story. I was in New Smyrna. The whole thing, they had big Mexicans with shirts on in the ocean. Why do you have your shirt on?
Yeah.
Well, Mexicans, I mean.
Yeah, but why is that?
But anyway,
I thought we were talking about blacks.
They don't eat dark meat.
Yeah.
Not everything. Dark. Anything dark.
Spicy meat. Mexican. Yeah.
The ocean draws in all types of weird fucks. You got the dude in a long sleeve shirt with a metal detector finding other people's trash that they didn't even care to look for in the first place.
First of all, what are they going to find? Fucking gold doubloons on the beach?
Gold doubloons.
Gold doubloons.
Like a fucking. Like a fucking chest of like gold, like
a skull,
scepters, and fucking
one-eyed Willie's fucking eyeball.
One-eyed Willie's.
You got the muscled-up Jersey Shore tattooed clowns who deserve to be on the World Trade Center on September 11th, and you got the fatty. And you got the fatty fat girls in way too small bathing suits who think they are good looking. Yes, you fat fucks, you look good. You're good enough to make one day a black guy very happy to be be your man. Sex on the beach.
Oh,
yeah. The drink is good.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I'm talking about the real thing. The real thing sucks. Yeah, that's what I want, as I'm kissing your nipple that feels like it's sanding off half my face from the sand, which is also infected with sand fleas that are crawling up my pecker hole to swell it up to the size of Paula Deen's bloated head.
Oh.
Fuck that.
I like Paula Deen.
You ever wonder, like,
that was my sinful seven.
If, like, someone's having sex, you know how, like, sometimes crabs live under the ground?
Yeah, of course they do. They like, a lot of majority of them live.
It's like they like shimmy up while you're doing it, and they're like I'd always be afraid of that.
Pinching
like,
your ass.
Like, yeah, get in there. Like,
dude, it's just gross. The sand, it feels like sandpaper.
The fleas,
and then I know somebody that actually has sand fleas.
Yeah, didn't you tell us?
I probably did. Yeah. I'd rather not repeat it.
Yeah.
They might be listening.
Yeah, probably not. Based on the views we've got lately,
no, that's true.
The only people watching are us, and we're cutting out halfway.
Carly.
Yeah, you have Coos News?
Hurry up.
That was a good one.
News, yeah.
Sound like a good suck-in for their crotch.
Yeah, that's a fucking loose one.
I've been hearing those lately.
Right, this one happened in Spain, where a...
España.
a driver of a train killed 79 people because he was on his phone while driving the
They're
train.
They're called conductors.
Yeah.
And he was going 90.
Driver of train.
And I know he was going 95 miles an hour where the speed limit on it was 40.
Yeah.
It's fucking awesome.
Was it 95? It says kilometers. Oh,
And one of the accounts I remember reading about this, it was like fucking carnage, like just body parts.
But like, he survived.
Yeah.
He survived. He was in the front of it.
He survived.
No shit. Well, good. Actually, now he has to live with that.
Because now
he's being charged with 79 counts of manslaughter.
Oh, I wonder how many years that is.
What happens is, you know how like you know how like in action movies where like the star like outruns the explosion.
Yeah.
The train just like detached and ran away as the rest
as everything else.
And then it jumped at the end.
Say what you want about trains. I will be on a train 10 times over than a fucking airplane.
Fuck yes.
I don't care if
week.
You are going 95 miles an hour. Bellowing down.
Because it's over like that.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, you're probably tossed around in your cart a little bit, and then probably the third hit on the...
Yeah.
Was gonna, like,
or let me put it this way. Everyone else in the car with me is getting smushed, and then I'll
then you're done. Unless like, you're the padding
like,
for everyone.
Boom, 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 boom. Just like, every time I hit something, there's someone between me and the fucking walls. Yeah. It's just like, everyone's flat like this against the wall.
Nice.
Yeah.
In other words, I know we want to end it real fast, but I just heard from Comic-Con that... you watch Family Guy still.
Yeah.
That they're actually killing off one of the Griffins.
Really?
Yeah. It was like huge news. They announced it, and then everyone in the audience went nuts.
Well, probably, if I had to guess, it'd
Chris.
Be Chris.
Me too.
Chris, yeah.
Either that or Meg, just because...
Meg's too obvious.
But that's what I think, but then I think it might be for... What's her name wants to leave because she's done it for so long.
Yeah,
she's on
the
bigger and better things.
Yeah.
Who?
But Meg would be too obvious. The voice of Meg. Why am I blanking out? The hottest... Mila Kunis. Thank you.
Oh, okay.
Only one of the hottest girls on the planet right now. She's so smoking hot.
Well, Seth Green does have like some kind of... Like association with like
that's true. That's true. So I don't know.
Who knows?
I just thought it was.
He can do whatever he wants at this point. Tell you the truth.
You know what? They could get rid of what's her name, the wife.
Lois.
Yeah, Lois.
Lois. Cool with that.
Yeah, whatever.
They also announced that the next Superman movie is gonna be Superman versus
and
Batman.
Batman. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, cool. Yeah.
But I don't care because Batman's not Christian Bale.
Yeah, that's true.
The only good Batman is Christian Bale.
They're bringing a new guy.
New guy, schmoo guy. That's so stupid.
That's
yeah, exactly.
I also heard in Comic-Con news that, what's her name, Arya Stark, is going to be...
Don't say anything if it's going to ruin it.
No, she's going to be one of the guest stars.
She's going to come on this podcast and have sex with us?
Oh, God, yeah.
When she's 18?
Yeah, of course, because she's not... So I guess that's the end of the podcast.
Yeah. let's leave it with that weird thought. All right, we'll see you everybody next week.
I'll be seeing the fucking north.